Translating Problems into Equations, Level 2. In this video, we're going to continue translating problems into equations. This time around, we will go over more challenging examples, making sure we use the three-step plan introduced in the previous video. Alright, let's go over the first example. Translate each problem into an equation. The length of a rectangle is 1 meter more than its width. The perimeter of the rectangle is 60 meters. In this example, we are dealing with a rectangle. So let's go ahead and draw a rectangle to help us visualize and analyze this problem. Recall that the first step is to identify the unknown variables. In this example, the unknown quantities are the length and width of the rectangle. Having identified our unknowns, we now have to assign variables to them. As a rule of thumb, we first want to assign the variable to the quantity for which we have the least amount of information. In this problem, notice that we have a description that relates the length with the width, but we don't have a description that relates the width with the length. This means that we should assign the variable to the width. So let's assign the letter x to it. Now that the width is represented by the variable x, the length of this rectangle would be denoted as the quantity x plus 1, since the length is 1 meter more than the width. Having assigned variables to both unknown quantities, we are ready to translate the word problem into an equation. Notice that we are given that the perimeter of this rectangle is equal to 60 meters. We're going to use this fact in combination with the variable expressions and relate them to form an equation. In order to accomplish this, we need to make use of a formula, specifically the formula for the perimeter of a rectangle. The perimeter is just going to be equal to the sum of all the sides of this rectangle. In other words, twice the length plus twice the width. In this problem, we know that the perimeter is equal to 60. In addition, we also know that the width is represented by the variable x, and the length is represented by the variable expression x plus 1. Substituting these expressions into the formula results in the following equation. 60 equals 2x plus 2 times the quantity x plus 1. And this is our equation. Keep in mind that you might have to use formulas in order to successfully translate a word problem into an equation. It all depends on the type of word problem that you're faced with. Alright, let's try the next example. A triangle has two equal sides, and a third side that is 15 centimeters long. The perimeter of the triangle is 50 centimeters. In this example, we are dealing with a triangle, so let's go ahead and draw a triangle. Let's first identify the unknowns in this problem. Notice that we are given the measurement of one side of the triangle, but have no idea what the measurement of the other two sides are. For this problem, the unknowns are the measurements of these two sides of the triangle. Next, let's assign variables to these unknowns. For the first sentence, we are told that this triangle has two equal sides. So we are actually dealing with an isosceles triangle, a triangle that has two of its sides with the same measurement. This means that we can assign the same variable to both sides, since they are equivalent. So let's assign each side with the variable x as follows. Now it's just a matter of translating these expressions into an equation. We first need to figure out how to relate all of these expressions with one another. Notice that we are told that the perimeter is equal to 50 centimeters. We can relate all the expressions by using the formula for the perimeter of a triangle. We essentially need to add all the sides of the triangle, so our equation will be equal to x plus 15 equals 50. And this is our final answer. Alright, up to this point, we have been going over examples that contain two unknowns. Now let's try some examples that contain three facts about three unknowns. Lewis is three times as heavy as his luggage. His luggage is 20 pounds heavier than his backpack. The weight of Lewis, his luggage, and backpack total 170 pounds. In this example, we actually have three unknowns as opposed to two unknowns, like in the previous problems. Regardless of the number of unknowns, the procedure is essentially the same. We first need to identify our unknowns. After reading the problem, it is clear that we are dealing with three unknowns. The first unknown is Lewis's weight. The second unknown is the weight of the luggage. And the third unknown is the weight of the backpack. Having identified the unknowns, we now need to choose a variable and represent the rest of the unknowns with this variable. First, let's figure out which unknown we absolutely have no information about. We know that Lewis's weight is 3 times the weight of his luggage. We also know that his luggage is 20 pounds heavier than his backpack. But we have no idea how the backpack is related to the other unknowns. So let's go ahead and represent the weight of his backpack with the variable x. This way, the weight of the luggage can be expressed as x plus 20. And Lewis's weight can be expressed as 3 times the weight of the luggage, or using our expressions as 3 times the quantity x plus 20. Now we need to translate these expressions into an equation. In the last sentence, we are told that the combined weight of the luggage, backpack, and Lewis's weight is equal to 170 pounds. So we can express this fact as follows. X plus the quantity x plus 20 plus 3 times the quantity x plus 20 equals 170. And this is our equation. When dealing with multiple unknowns, the procedure is essentially the same. Just be a bit more careful and make sure you relate the correct unknowns with one another. Alright, let's go over the next example. Maribel, Dave, and Henry have $180 together. Maribel has 3 times more money than Dave. Dave has 2 times more money than Henry. Similar to the previous problem, we first need to identify all of the unknown quantities. In this particular problem, the unknown quantities are the amount of money that each person has. In this example, we have 3 unknown quantities. Once we have determined the unknown quantities, we are ready to assign variables to them. Let's first determine which unknown quantity we have the least information on. We know that Maribel has 3 times more money than Dave. We also know that Dave has 2 times more money than Henry. But we have no information of how Henry's amount is related to the other 2 amounts. Hence, we will assign the variable x to Henry's amount. This means that Dave's amount will be represented as 2x. And lastly, Maribel's amount will be represented as 3x. Having assigned a variable to each unknown quantity, we are ready to translate the word problem into an equation. We know that if we were to add the amount of all 3 individuals, it would add up to $180. So we can denote this relation as 3x plus 2x plus x equals 180. And this is our equation. Alright, let's go over the final example. A pipe 10 feet long is cut into 3 pieces. One piece is 1 foot longer than the shortest piece, and 2 feet shorter than the longest piece. Alright, this word problem is perhaps the most challenging problem in this video. Let's use everything that we learn to tackle it. Let's first make a drawing of our pipe, broken into 3 pieces. Let's first start by identifying the unknowns. In this example, we have no idea how much each of the pieces measure. So the length of each of the pieces will be our unknowns. Next, let's go ahead and assign variables to each of the unknown lengths. Because we have 3 distinct pieces, we will label them as the shortest, medium, and longest piece, so we can easily distinguish them. From the second sentence, we are told that one piece is 1 foot longer than the shortest piece. So let's go ahead and assign a variable to the shortest piece. Let's assign the variable x. With this assignment, the medium piece will be denoted as x plus 1. Finally, we are also given that this same piece, the medium piece, is 2 feet shorter than the longest piece. Let's think about this. If the medium piece is 2 feet shorter than the longest piece, that means the longer piece is 2 feet longer than the medium piece. In other words, it can be denoted as x plus 1 the length of the medium piece, plus 2, since it is 2 feet longer. Having assigned the variables to all three unknowns, we are ready to translate the word problem into an equation. From the first sentence, we know that the original pipe length was equal to 10. So if we were to add the individual pieces, they should add up to 10. So our final equation is equal to x plus the quantity x plus 1 plus the quantity x plus 1 plus 2 equals 10. Alright, make sure you read the word problem as many times as you need to. You really need to understand the problem before you start identifying unknowns and assigning variables to them. Okay, in our next video, we will expand the skills developed so far and start solving word problems over a given domain.